Do you have fat in your liver? In this video, I will discuss the 6 most harmful foods and the 7 most beneficial. Moreover, I will include the 3 most effective habits to assist in combating liver fat. First, let's examine the relationship of the foods you should avoid. Number 1. Avoid processed meats. Salami, sausage, hot dogs, paraham, and turkey breast are foods many consider healthy, but in reality, they contain a large amount of preservatives, including nitrates and nitrites, which have been linked to an increased risk of cancer. Therefore, in addition to the issue of liver fat, it's important to also consider your overall health. Some types of cancer, such as intestinal, stomach, and colon cancer, may have their chances increased by the consumption of processed meats. This information is not just my opinion. There are scientific studies that prove this. Therefore, it's essential to avoid processed meats. And why do I say avoid? If it's not possible to eliminate them completely, try to reduce consumption as much as possible. This will bring benefits to your health. Number 2, avoid foods high in saturated fats, such as pork lard and coconut oil. Many believe coconut oil is healthy. However, I must inform you that it contains a high amount of saturated fat. If you suffer from fat accumulation in the liver, it's important to avoid this type of fat. Despite there being much information on the internet praising coconut oil, scientific research indicates that foods high in saturated fat, like coconut oil, can exacerbate inflammation and fat accumulation in the liver. Therefore, they must be avoided. Another example of food with saturated fat that should be avoided is ice cream. It's crucial to restrict these types of foods. Number 3. Avoid processed and ultra-processed foods, or those with a high sodium index. Within these categories fall, for example, instant noodles and frozen lasagnas. These are examples of ultra-processed foods. Moreover, many sauces and condiments, including some types of ketchup and mustard, contain a large amount of preservatives. It's advisable to avoid this type of food in your diet. But don't worry, I'll also inform you about the best foods. It's crucial, however, to be aware of the worst. Knowing what to avoid is as important as knowing which are the healthiest foods. Number 4, avoid alcohol. Alcoholic beverages, you probably already know this, but it's important to emphasize that alcohol can exacerbate hepatic steatosis, that is, the accumulation of fat in the liver, especially if the liver fat is caused by some specific factor. Alcohol consumption should be 0. It's highly recommended that you completely eliminate alcohol from your diet and daily routine. Consult with a specialist to better understand how alcohol affects metabolism and the impact it has on your body's functioning. Therefore, remove alcohol from your daily life to improve your liver health. Number 5, avoid simple sugars. Here, the concern goes beyond refined or confectioner's sugar that is used in desserts or in coffee. I hope you don't add sugar to your coffee, but if you do, know that this will increase your blood sugar level, requiring an insulin spike. From a metabolic point of view, this is harmful to those with liver fat, as it worsens hepatic steatosis. Beyond refined sugar, simple carbohydrates are also problematic. During digestion, your body turns them into sugar. Therefore, foods like white bread, pasta, and cakes, which are simple carbohydrates, should be avoided. Note that I'm referring to simple carbohydrates, not complex ones, which can be included in the diet. I'm not against all carbohydrates, just simple ones and refined sugar. Number 6, avoid fructose syrup or corn syrup. This is considered one of the worst, perhaps the worst. Be careful with fructose syrup in your diet. It's essential to check food labels to ensure you're not consuming fructose syrup. Scientifically, fructose syrup can exacerbate hepatic steatosis or the accumulation of fat in the liver. Therefore, it's crucial to avoid and restrict as much as possible the consumption of corn syrup or fructose syrup. Now let's talk about the best habits and foods. First, I'll discuss the habits and then the list of the best foods. What are the best habits? Number 1, do physical exercise. It's essential to make an effort to include physical exercise in your routine. As from a metabolic perspective, it is fundamental for building muscle mass and improving insulin resistance. which is crucial in treating liver fat. Here, we're not just talking about the gym. Activities like walking are also very beneficial. Studies show that walking at least 150 minutes a week, spread over 3 or more days, for example, 50 minutes 3 times a week or 30 minutes 5 times a week can significantly help in the process of reducing liver fat. In the case of grade 1 and 2 liver fat, it's possible to even reverse the condition. In grade 3, it's more difficult, but maintaining an exercise routine already represents a great advance in treatment, preventing the condition from worsening. In mild to moderate stages, reversal is possible. It's important to note that this is not just my opinion, but a protocol based on studies. In addition to walking, other options like water aerobics and running are also excellent. Number 2, control weight. This tip is crucial. Understanding this point can be a turning point in the treatment of liver fat. Many people stop treatment because they adopt extremely restrictive diets that promote rapid weight loss in a short period of time. Surprisingly, this type of diet can worsen liver fat, even causing necrosis, which is the death of liver cells. It's paradoxical to think that by following a diet, therefore, some people get confused and think about giving up treatment, believing it's not working. However, what's important here is gradual weight control. The American Diabetes Society recommends that healthy and gradual weight loss for the liver be a maximum of 1 kg per week. Number 3, seek medical follow-up. When a patient presents with liver fat, it's crucial to also evaluate them for other metabolic diseases, such as cholesterol changes, blood pressure, and other conditions that can aggravate liver fat, like hypothyroidism. Without proper treatment, it becomes very difficult to effectively improve from other metabolic issues. Therefore, the evaluation and control of thyroid function, as well as other risk factors I mentioned, are fundamental in the treatment and management of the patient's health with liver fat. By implementing these food habits and avoiding the foods I've mentioned, you will be on the right track to improving your liver health. Remember to consult with a healthcare professional for personalized guidance based on your individual health condition.